Closed. Apparently it's opening in 3 minutes, according to these guys over here, so I'm going to wait. And wait. Most pubs hate it when I come early. They want me to come when it's even, when it's busy, but I quite like it to be dead, to be honest. Time to go inside, people. Time to go inside. I'm gonna try one of these ones, you know, sort of I've never tried before.
Yeah, of course.
Cool. I'll go for the 1858 Championship beer.
Yeah,
the
sure.
Landlord. Pale ale, not my favourite, but I'm gonna try
this
it.
This one's not your favourite?
Pale ale in general, but I'm gonna give it a go. It's actually really good, really flavoury. I like it. Biddy Hill, Hamo Square, Central Station. I was going to start my filming today there, but I thought let's go Oxton ways and then head to Thurstaston. Can you see that little wobble? I think the screw is coming out. I'll have to fix that. So annoying. You can probably hear it jingling. So. Pint at the landlord's, £4.20 I think. And this is in the Carnarvon Castle, not the actual Carnarvon Castle, the pub. That's really good, that. I'm glad I took a lucky dip today. So the plan today is walk to Thurstaston Beach. There was someone who messaged me who has not been able to make it back to the country for years, and that was their favourite place. I'm not going to be able to find that message. It'll just be swamped in with me personal messages and everything. I don't know whether it was Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, but I remember someone saying so. This video is for you. See how many miles we'll have to walk? 6.5 miles. Approximately 2 hours. 10 minutes if we don't stop in pubs. Thank you, mate. That pint was lovely. Bye now. Tell you what, I did enjoy that pint, and now I've got my trek to, oh, this feels so fragile. Gonna see if I can have a play around with it. But yeah, it's like 8 miles up that way. Townfield Lane, I believe it's a bit quicker that way. So yeah, I'm just gonna time warp all the way down this road, listen to a bit of music, and that's it for right now. Thank you. getting down here. This is uncharted territory for me. Look up there, landscape up there, and then somewhere in between is the halfway house. Pint number two. Gonna pop, well, if you count. Well, I suppose it is pint number two, that was only a bottle. So we're gonna pop into the Swan for one. I don't think they were laughing at me, but they could have been. $3.95, I tell you what, for a Stella, it's pretty cheap. Very spacious inside as well, but I am going outside. So yeah, first pint ever in the Swan. Tell you what, the prices aren't bad. So apparently since the Carnarvon Castle, we've traveled 4 minutes closer. So 2 hours. 6 minutes to go, plus a pint. I often get people asking me which are my favourite pubs on the Wirral. And I would say the pubs that are head and shoulders above the rest are the Luke's, the Old House of Home, the Swinging Arm, Molly's. And I really like the Record label in New Brighton. I've only been there once. I was drinking with La Vida Liverpool and Razzmatazz, the band. They're pretty cool guys. Yeah, so those are my favourites. I've obviously not been to every pub, but yeah. Also, I think my next Walking Wonders is going to be a really good one. There's a guy who's walking the length of the country barefoot from the Wirral. I'll be doing the Wirral leg of his walk. He's doing some good things, raising some money, so let's hope he not only gets to his target, he exceeds it as well, because I'm really rooting for the guy, to be honest with you. And that's the Swan. On we go, on we go. I would say this flyover splits the Wirral in half. You have the towns on one side, then more countryside, then a few little towns. Now it's straight down past Landerkin. Gonna see where that woman tipped the car. So we'll have a little pop in, see if I'm allowed in. And then it's continue on to Thurstaston Beach. They complaining about dropping to the floor. Oh, no. I saw it fall out the bottom of the GoPro. One nightmare, it's like a tiny, tiny screw. I'm gonna have a quick look. I doubt I'm gonna find it, but I'll have a quick look. Two's just dropped. No! No! Definitely gonna have a look now. gone, but not forgotten. Found one. Not gonna lie, quite happy with finding one. Going to give up. I think it's time to give up. One's better than none. And you can buy them anyway, so just now the plan is not to lose this and then go and tighten them all in. I've been complaining that it's shaking, so I knew it was coming loose. You could say it's my own fault, but I never thought one would drop out then the other would drop out instantly. Never thought that in a million years.
I'm wondering why I got out of bed at all. Morning rain clouds up my window and I can't see it all.
Cars driving in, so obviously allowed in. So apparently they came in through here. They must have turned around somewhere, because I can't see no destruction. Can't see no skid marks. Wow, weren't expecting that. I thought it'd just be all here. My cousin's buried down there. Am I going to pay some respects? It's all cordoned off there, so they must have came down here, around there, and tipped the car on its head. Anyway, I'm just going to check my cousin's grave and then catch you all up there. Bad news, I've lost three of them now, just fell off. But I'll tell you what, look at the scenery. Absolutely lovely walk. I think I might switch camera. I do have a spare one from another GoPro that I'd never used, so I'll just swap it over when I get home. I was actually quite lucky because I had my headphones in when it fell off. I reached for my pocket, lifted it out, I was like, oh my god, wonder where I dropped that. Ran back a couple of steps and there it was, so I'm quite happy with that. I would have lost this video and nothing else because I've transferred all the old stuff. And that's ready to be edited. Anyway, here's Airby Village. Off to civilization again. Not so lucky if you live around here. It's gorgeous, but just taking a little detour to say hello to the horses. Hello. Hello. Looks like I'm being swerved. Hello, no, come on back. Oh, Jesus. Not sure whether that was me funny bone or a lucky shock. Must have been a lucky car. No, it's probably scared of the electric wires. I'm not going to touch it again. Hello. Anyway, let's get to that beach. I wonder if they are electric. If anyone else has been shocked by them, leave a comment and let me know. I don't have the minerals to touch it twice. Up there, there's a little yellow tag on the line, so yeah, let's assume it is electric. Won't be playing with that anymore. Anyway, this is Airby Village. So right now we're at the Shippin's pub and kitchen. I have been here before and the staff are lovely, but I want to get there. And shout out to the boys that were driving down there and gave me the shout out. Fair play to you too. You've got a private members club over there, but what's caught my attention, the Anchor pub and dining. I need to go and change my camera over so I don't have to hold it and I can position things and stuff. So I'm going to stop for another pint at the Anchor pub and dining. Let's give it a go, let's check it out. I tell you what, Airby Road, Thurstaston Road, where that meets is stunning. The views are tremendous.